So hi everyone, my name is Mark. I'm from South Africa and I'm presenting this performance called Territory. And from my experience over the last day, I've decided to talk about my performance and then perform, which is something I wouldn't normally do. I would just do it. And the reason why I've done it is there was a discussion around performance, and there was this. What I took away from that discussion was that it's almost as though these performances are quite random and then they're just open to any interpretation of any people come and participate, but then it can be quite chaotic. And what I took away was this performance is coming from quite a bit of workshop, and I've got concepts and ideas, and I need to get that clear before we engage, and in that sense I'm coming with some rules or some guidelines or ways in to understanding or to showing my meaning. And then this particular performance was workshopped over a number of exhibitions, and then I performed it at a conference in Cape Town in July, and I was collaborating with three other people. So this time it's very different in that it's just myself. I assume the audience. And I'm really exploring the idea with the true performance that performer audience gets learned, that we all get involved in this. So the first stage of this, firstly the title is Territory, and I'm exploring the idea that identity is a colonizer of consciousness. So it's a territorializer of consciousness. And I based it on two experiences that I've had. One was a psychedelic experience and the other was a deep meditative experience where I had an experience which I arrived in a place I would describe as home, as stillness, and I had a very clear message that the thing that's always available to me, that the thing that disrupts that, prevents me from experiencing that is whatever I'm identifying with. So I came away with that, and that was quite a few years ago, with this idea of, well, identity seems to be a problem. And also, examining identity, I also felt a lot of the stuff I'm identifying with, I inherited. It wasn't stuff that I necessarily chose. It came to me through my social upbringing, my cultural upbringing. And I'm stuck with, what do I do with this? Having a psychedelic experience, having a meditation experience, showed me that I was able to experience myself, experience consciousness in a way that I didn't know. So I've set about exploring more experiences that break open identities, so experience that kind of pure consciousness. And so then it comes to the performance, which is, it's all metaphors of that, of the various experiences. So my first symbol is, I'm taking clothing, and I'm using clothing as a symbol for identity. And so what the performance is about are various procedures that open us up to, or could open us up to other experiences of ourselves beyond our identity. So using clothing as a symbol for that, the first procedure is to what I call filleting. It's filleting the fabric of identity from the seams, which is liberating the fabric of identity from the categories, that this is a shirt or this is underwear, or I'm a man, or I'm whatever social construct is. Which then leaves me with the virtual fabric. All the identity is then virtual, becomes virtual. So these sort of boxes on top there. The next procedure is to then develop yarn, which, and I'll just start demonstrating. I then start cutting the fabric into a continuous line, into a continuous thread. As you can see, it's a really laborious and often years thing, very boring, very slow. And then I developed new yarns. And this was from the genes. And that in a process is, for me, it's I'm sitting with a narrative, becoming a narrative. I'm sitting with my story. I'm sitting with the story of what that garment used to be for me, what that identity was. And then I bind, which is another process of cocooning, sitting with, putting together. And then in collaboration, if I'm working with you, we could then swap stories, like me listening to your story, and then by listening to your story, it's adding to my understanding of becoming, and that way around. And then the next process is the knitting, which, I'm redoing an identity. Apparently we need some kind of identity, we need to have some kind of ego's construct. Which in this case I've just allowed it to emerge. And for me what these processes represent is identity, which was in the realm of category and quite stiff. It's now the actual material has changed into something that's stretchy and they can pleat, they can come undone. It can be unpicked, it can be reused. It's no longer just within that format. And how these procedures, processes, are ways that we develop this kind of fabric of identity. So having said all that, I invite you to come and develop a fluid identity. That's a sock. So now I'm going to go into performance mode to get to rest. And maybe you're going to surrender a garment, which we could fit it. I find these very interesting. This was a skull. I find them quite beautiful as drawings. And please, this is a welcome feedback and input and discussion, and it's all about talk and chatting. So,
I basically engaging yourself. It's basically engaging yourself.
It is. But it's about
So it's basically like we can't sleep. It's something to do that makes you go to sleep. Yeah? Like a meditation. So it's a bit like doing a mantra.
Yeah.
is. It's just something emerges that I'm not in control of.
Thank you.
Thank you.